Okay, that was too much current.
That was amazing.
That was about the best thing I've ever seen.
It has been non-stop crazy. We've been up all night.
Previously on Searching for Seashells.
We arrive for the first time in stunning Exuma, Bahamas.
We explore the area around Highborn Key.
And go south to find one of the prettiest anchorages we have ever seen.
Pick them up.
Are you joking?
No, pick them up.
Oh no, I would never touch them.
Pick them up.
No. You pick them up.
All right.
Are you going? No, Sheldon. I think he's dead. Dead?
Yeah, he's dead.
I guess it was a rough ride over the rocks.
Make some good bait.
The wind clocked from the east to the southwest, allowing us to leave Norman's Pond. We ventured just a little north to Saddleback Cay. It's a gorgeous anchorage, however, it has some of the strongest current we have ever experienced at any anchorage.
Sheldon's taking a look at what's underneath the boat. It's just a beautiful anchorage. Current rips through it. It's just pretty cool. How's the current?
It's strong, but I can overcome it. That's strong. It's strong. I'm gonna have to walk up and float down.
Okay, that was too much current. I can only go sideways. The boat is right there. So I've got a drift snorkel in the current to the boat again. Take a hold of the anchor, check the anchor, and then get back aboard, because if you got tired, couldn't make it, you would drift out to sea, I guess.
At Saddleback, and we're gonna go fill up some water at Highborn and then look for another anchorage. Little tiny channel to go through. We're at high tide, shallow, 4 feet, Sheldon. I don't think we should do it.
Cindy, we got luck. We've been going a lot shallower than this. We're good, just going down again. We're just gonna cut it right out of the moon here. So there's a sandbar right here.
Yes.
That's where we walked last night.
You're going right next to the sandbar. Kind of nerve-wracking for me, but Sheldon doesn't seem to mind.
He's a little bit of a diggy, isn't he?
Saving the reef from the lionfish.
He does enjoy many of them too.
We're headed to Hammerhead Gulch.
So the tide is coming, already starting to come in. We were going to take the mooring here. They do have a mooring. But we're going to do a, we're going to drift
it. Head of the live aboard dive operation. Tanger talked to us in his dinghy. He said, so we can do the reef right here, but the tide's starting to come in. And it starts to rip real fast. So what we're going to do is go past the rock up here and take advantage of it. I'll tie the dinghy to myself, and we'll just drift with the dinghy. We'll drift all the way up to the reef, and if you want to do any more, we'll tie to the mooring that they're on.
Oh, look at their boat there.
Lobster Cay anchorage.
Yes, no lobster.
I expected to see a bunch of lobsters in there yesterday, but must be all picked over.
Shelling got the dinghy tied on.
To me.
Yeah, I'm going to hold on to the line or Sheldon.
That was about the best thing I've ever seen.
We have got to 100%
get our
scuba gear.
that definitely requires scuba gear.
There was towers and caverns. Oh, it was beautiful.
That was amazing.
It's an underwater, it's just like Finding Nemo. It's beautiful down there. It's an underwater world.
Have you seen a reef shark or something like that?
Take two. We can't help ourselves. Oh, we gotta drift it again.
We love that so much. We gotta do it again. That's amazing.
Yeah. And when we get our scuba gear, we're gonna come back for a week and explore each tower down there. And get to know the fish on a more personal level.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm gonna name them.
End of a perfect day.
Yeah, it's one of the best days I can ever think of.
I know. It has been. Did you find a plane?
This is take three of find a plane.
Yeah, it's inside.
It's on the wrong side of the key.
It's in the most obvious.
Don't listen to the coordinates on the paddy site.
Yeah.
Follow nav charts. It's written there, plane. That's it there?
Yep, straight ahead. Stick it out of the water. Quite an easy find.
Thank you.
4 a.m. and we have been rocking the whole night. Sheldon is, it's craziness. Sheldon, be careful. It has been non-stop crazy. Can't even tell you how crazy. Sheldon thinks he's gonna put on a line out there. It's kind of rocky though. To bring us side on. We've been up all night. Super tired. Sheldon? You're okay, are you? Sheldon? Sheldon? Oh, you're on the side of the boat. I thought you were in the back of the boat. Oh. What are you doing?
I'm trying to sort of spring the anchor so that the bow pulls into the waves a bit.
This is the craziness of boating sometimes. You miss out on a good night's sleep every now and then.
My big light?
Big light. Really, really bad night. Anyways, I couldn't stand up a few minutes ago. Sheldon finally got this rig working out. Look at this. Us from violently. I couldn't even get coffee this morning, but since you've got that done, I've got coffee on.
So I wanted to show you guys something before I dismantle what my little rig here I did for my anchor, because it helped us a lot. So hopefully this comes out without too much wind noise. We had a 25 sustained wind for about 2 days, gusting into the 30s. Here, our cover of the kayak a bit. But anyway, the wind was coming out of the east. We're off Normans Cay, and for some reason, we had a big swell coming out of the northwest. So it's probably some effect of strong winds coming in through one of the inlets. Came in, but we were all night, the first night, rocking violently, really, really bad. We didn't know where we were going to go. So I thought, let's see if I get it. It's not died down all that much yet. Probably less wind here. Yeah, okay. So yeah, we were being violently rocked this way. It's more comfortable when a boat is pitching fore and aft like that. But when it's going like that, it's a mess. And we had it right on the beam all night long. We got zero sleep that night. I read a little while ago about something called a swell bridle. And what the guy did was tie a line to his stern to the anchor chain and then pulled so that the boat was 90 degrees to the wind and caught the swell on the bow. I moved my snubber or bridle hook to the mantis chain hook to the second cleat on the bow and loosened the chain a little bit, and that allowed me to take the bridle to the stern cleat. What that allowed me to do was actually pull that in until I was really diagonal to the swell that was coming. And you know what? It got really comfortable then. We had no more problems. It worked really, really well. Really well. But 100 feet out is my rock to Vulcan. So, like I said, we were gusting into the 30s, sustained winds in the mid-20s, and the wind was pushing us side on, and that did not budge 1 inch. So that speaks at least a little bit to the how well the Rockna Vulcan holds. I don't think it's completely sand. It's grassy sand, so it's hard packed a little bit. And I think it just dug way down in. We didn't go anywhere. Anyway, I'm going to dismantle this thing now and I'll be doing it again.
What does it take to feel this alive? Every day we're gonna try. What does it take to feel this alive? Chase down a